moving, moving, though they're disapproving. Keep them doggies moving, Rawhide. Don't try to understand them, just rope, throw and brand. Soon we'll be living high and wide. My heart's calculating, my true love will be waiting. Be waiting at the end of my ride. Move them on, hit them up, hit them up. Move them on, hit them up, Rawhide. Cut them out, ride them in, ride them in, let them out, cut them out, ride them in, Rawhide. Rawhide.
Cattle drives mostly hard work, doing without, being alone. It's warming yourself in a rainstorm with no fuel but buffalo chips. Spreading your duds on an anthill to get out the vermin. It's being and doing things you don't rightly ask of two-legged humans, unless they're cowboys. Add discipline and loyalty to the list, all for $30 a month. It's a big strain on a man. You have to expect something to give along the way and bust wide open. I'm in a position to know. I'm Gil Favor, trail boss.
I tell you, the wind was blowing so strong, this friend of mine, he had a $20 gold piece when he got swooped up. And when he came down and he looked at that 20, I'll be darned if it hadn't turned to two 50-cent pieces and a plug nickel. What's the matter with you, Jaspers? I told that story maybe 10 times. It's always good for a laugh. Getting mighty hard to amuse.
Maybe nobody feels as funny. Maybe there's nothing to laugh at.
You think Niosha was Kansas City or St. Louis or something?
Maybe it ain't much of a town. But it's a place to go, something to do.
I'll give you something to do. Keep you busy all night. And that's picking the teeth out of the back of your throat.
Ease off, Brad. Sit down, Rowdy.
2 whole days and nothing to do but take a long squint at the sun or a quick nap in the shade. It's enough to drive a guy out of his mind.
We busted her and got across. A good horse for to thank.
That devil river's going to take a lot of busting, Mr. Nolan. You trying to work a hoodoo to get us over on the other side?
You fool-headed wrangler, don't ever come bulging in on a skittery herd like that.
Huh?
The smell of water's nagging at them. We're keeping them thirsty.
How come?
Oh, you're pitiful, Yank. You see, by the time that river goes down, these cattle will be so bone dry, they'll be rushing to get in that water. We won't have to push so hard to get them across.
Hmm. You know, seems plain unreasonable to keep everyone from going into town, as long as we're laid up anyhow. Boys are getting mighty breechy. Everybody's snapping at everybody else.
Don't let that be your worry, Boston. Mr. Favor has reasons. Good reasons.
Guess so. Say, Mr. Nolan, how long do you think it would take a low-down horse wrangler like me to be a top rider like you?
Well, the world got created in 6 days. You might make it in 6.
Thanks.
Years.
Now get that thing out of here, Jesse, and don't make me tell you again. You're not turning this chuck wagon into a blatten cart.
You ain't so hard as you make out to be, Wishbone. Only thing hard about you's them biscuits you put out. Look at her. Just nothing but a rack of bones.
I'm not going against Mr. Favor's orders. There's enough raw feelings in this outfit already.
Now look, just who cares about Mr. Favor?
Calves have got no cash value. nothing but bother. All their ma's always bawling after them, riling up the herd. Either shoot them or beef them for grub.
Well, not little old Buttermilk. Now, look, Wishbone, you're going to take good care of little Buttermilk. You're going to keep her warm and safe and out of sight. Now, you go ahead and rustle up some milk so she don't start missing her mammy. Now, you hear me? Now, go on. Overgrown lummox. You couldn't help it because you was born no more than me. Ain't no reason why you should suffer for it. I know.
Good evening, gentlemen. I trust we're welcome.
And then, gentlemen. Let's not have so much formality.
On your feet, Lieutenant. Attention! Force of habit, gentlemen.
What do you want, Millet?
Perhaps I should explain. Lieutenant Favor served under me during the last stages of the recent conflict. How have you been, my good friend?
Fine. Till now.
I should be offended. You knew my family owned half this county, including the town of Nyosha, and yet you kept your men away as though it harbored a plague.
Doesn't it?
What in the world could you possibly mean, Mr. Favor?
I think this ex-colonel here knows my meaning.
I think I do.
I need every hand I've got to get this herd to Sedalia.
I was under the impression the institution of slavery was abolished. I thought even Southerners were free to come and go as they please. Was I wrong in that, gentlemen? Your lord and master here knows that I'm recruiting men of stout hearts to reestablish the Confederacy. And a way of life that's dear to every Southerner worthy of the name.
These men are trying to forget the war. You're wasting your breath.
Suppose we let them decide. Allow me to present Miss Narcissa Adams, gentlemen. The lady has some literature that may awaken your dead pride.
You're just a little weanling, aren't you?
You make it mighty interesting, ma'am. Even for a Yankee.
You're anything but a little weanling. You're a man.
I'm mindful that some of you may be lacking in formal education. So, if you will allow me, your call to destiny, join the new Confederacy of Panama. If you are a Southerner and refuse to crawl under Yankee arrogance and oppression, adventure and wealth await you. Plantations in a tropical paradise with willing natives to serve. 50 gold dollars when you sign up. Arms and uniforms furnished free. Signed, Colonel Warren Millet, first Emperor of the Confederacy of Panama. Headquarters, Nyosha, Texas.
You've had your say, Millet. Now take this woman and get out.
One final word. Think to your future, men. There's nothing here for you but jackrabbit stew and mesquite beans.
paltry trail wages you'll leave behind in some northern railhead, then you're back where you started from, broke.
You were leaving, Millet.
Come, my dear.
There's plenty of the right kind of excitement in Iosha, boy.
And plenty of liquor, if you should decide to talk things over.
It's an exciting picture, huh, Mr. Favor?
If you're partial to pipe dreams. You men know how many ranches south of the Nueces are depending on us to get their brands to market. I can't force you to stay. But if I find any man preaching around camp, using this for a text, he's got a fight on his hands.
Look, boy, I don't read so good, but it's... Everything that the colonel said, is that all written down here?
Yes. Just like he said.
It is it? It is. Looks like there's places further south than south, huh? Oh, Colonel, I've been reading this thing real careful, like, but there's just one thing I want to know.
Yes, Mr. Childress.
Well, is it true, like you say, that wherever this place is, or whatever name it goes by, that if a man goes there, he can be what he wants to be? Is that true? Is it true?
Of course it's true, Jesse. That's exactly what Colonel Millet wants you to understand.
Oh. You're real thoughtful of me, Miss Narcy.
Go on. Drink up. To the power and the glory. A good drink dries up all the foolish, dull, and cruddy vapors environing the brain. It illumines the face and impels the heart to deeds of courage.
Oh, Colonel, you said that real pretty.
So did someone else before me. Well, Mr. Childress, if you have any other questions, Miss Narcy will be glad to answer them, I'm sure. Uh-huh. I have some business downstairs in the saloon.
That's all right, girl, that's all right.
What's the matter, Jesse?
Huh. You want to know something? I can't even read. I can't understand half of what the colonel says with all them fancy words. You know, I never seen a round map like that before in my whole life.
Jesse, you just believe me. None of that is the full measure of a man.
Well, what is?
It's what you have in your heart to make of yourself.
Go on.
If you listen to Colonel Millet, you'll be a leader worthy of anybody's respect.
Yours?
Any woman's.
Go on talking, Miss Narcy, and promising things. You know, Miss Narcy, I could listen to you forever. Thank you, ma'am.
Last call for breakfast! Oh, come on now!
Give me that! All right, rise and shine, you life spit drags! Everybody up, rise and shine! You're looking at the man that can holler louder. Just...
Jesse, it sure is.
Here I come! Yeah! you're looking at a soldier in the Grand Army of the New Confederacy of Panama. You boys can go ahead polishing your britches in a saddle if you want it. But not this old son. Who wants to be a stinking cowhand anyhow? All you do is get kicked and gouged wherever you go. But I seen the light. The colonel showed me the light.
Sure it wasn't that woman?
You leave Miss Narcy out of this. She's a fine southern lady.
Guess you didn't believe me last night, Jess.
You mean just you and me? Tooth and claw? He means just him and me. Tooth and claw.
Your
breakfast. Shouldn't have said nothing about Miss Narcy. She's a fine southern lady.
I heard you the first time, Jesse.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Favor. I didn't mean to hurt you so much, but Miss Narcy is a fine southern lady. Oh, there's one more thing you're going to be real sore at me about. That little old calf, you asked me to go out and kill it. Well, trail rules or no trail rules, I just didn't have the heart. So I'm taking her with me.
Yes, sir. Get the herd started.
You don't mean that, Mr. Favor.
I was afraid of something like this. I can't risk losing even one more man on fool's bait.
Well, that river's still big swimming. We could lose a lot more than just the herd.
Don't argue. Saddle your horses, the best mounts from the remuda. We're going across the river. Anybody can't swim, say so now. You can raft across with the wagons.
I'll make it all right, Mr. Favor.
All right. Let's roll. Don't let them balk when they hit the water. Make them swim.
All right, you were thirsty. Now get your hinders wet.
Keep that drag closing in. Keep them closing in.
losing cattle fast. Turn them back.
Couldn't even find his body.
Only last night he asked me how long it'd take him to be a top hand. We won't ever know that now, will we, Mr. Favor?
Sure gonna be tough writing his folks.
Don't even know if he had any. Never got that close to him. Don't even know his real name. Just Boston.
Why didn't the fool kid say he couldn't swim?
You remember Fredericksburg? Remember how those Yanks kept trying to come over that stone wall at the foot of Mary Heights? We felt ashamed shooting them down, but they kept coming. Well, I reckon Northerners got their pride, too.
Going somewhere?
I was wrong in what you done today, Mr. Favor.
I can be wrong.
The Yankee boy. Things like that could happen on any crossing, but we shouldn't have even tried it.
You got more to say?
You let Millet booger you into it.
I saw the way you looked at those handbills, the way you looked at the woman. It wasn't hard to read your minds.
Maybe you were right. So we're joining up with the colonel.
You found the excuse you were looking for.
That's the way you put it.
You won't feel good about it for long. Tomorrow, maybe the next day, you'll think it over. You won't be able to look each other in the eye. I'll be in Nyosha tomorrow, just in case.
The first recruit, Narcissa. Welcome, volunteer.
Reporting for orders, Colonel.
My first order is to commission you in the rank of captain.
Oh, thank you, Colonel. Thank you.
Captain Childress, carry on.
Attention! Right shoulder arm. Right face! Right face! Form by fours! Form by fours! Forward by the trap! March!
Ah, Lieutenant.
The war is over. The name is Favor.
If you hadn't come, I would have requested the honor of your presence.
Why?
I still think I can interest you in the new Confederacy of Panama, if I make it tempting enough.
There's only room for one emperor.
Double time! Fire!
We can't go on like this. We've had enough.
Something on your mind, Mayor Hayslip?
I've seen this town all through the war. I helped keep it alive. What we want is peace and a chance to build it up. You won't let us.
Did you dismiss this man, Captain Childress?
I'll kill anybody that tries to stop me from saying my piece. You keep at us about living high on the hog, somewhere in the jungle. A place no one ever heard of. You got all these people stirred up drilling and marching when they ought to be working. And now you're bringing in these cowboys. What do you got stewing around in that crazy mind of yours?
Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it!
Just run him out, Captain.
I'll go. With you here, the town ain't worth living in.
He won't show his face in town again. Have your men store their arms in the arsenal, Captain.
Arsenal? Oh, you mean the livery stable. All right, men, stack your arms in the livery stable. Hurry!
Then you can adjourn to the saloon. A little self-indulgence is good for the spirit.
What you looking at Favor like that for?
A lady tries to be gracious under all circumstances, Jessup.
You ain't never gonna look at no man again like that. Understand?
Why, you... You mustn't be silly, Jesse.
Understand?
We could talk matters over in my quarters over the saloon, but that hardly seems fitting.
You still think we have something to talk about?
Why don't you have dinner with me at my plantation house?
Plantation?
Oh, the wrong name, perhaps, in this dreary country. But it happens to be an exact replica of the Tidewater mansion my grandfather built in Virginia.
I think I will take you up on that. The mayor said something I'd like to know more about.
Good. I'll expect you at 7. The Millet place is on the other side of town. You can't miss it. It looms up on the prairie like a mirage. But it's very real. A fading symbol of gracious life, now vanished from the earth.
There's a man going round, taking names.
Welcome, Mr. Lieutenant. Most welcome. I've been waiting.
Mr. Favor, how nice to see you. Won't you come in, please? Zachariah.
Yes, Miss Narcy.
Finish your song for Mr. Favor.
Oh, death is the man taking names, oh, death is the man taking names. Well, he took my master's name and has left my heart in pain. Yes, death is the man taking names.
Thank you.
Where's Millet?
If I know him, and I should, he's up there polishing his medals. Or just looking back at the time when he was really something.
Isn't he anymore?
You know better.
I didn't think you did.
Oh, Gil, please do it for me. I need you. He isn't man enough for a job as big as this. All he's good for is talking and strutting. But you could make it all come true.
Emperor?
Oh, there are plenty of ways of getting rid of him once we get down there. Oh, Gil, it could be paradise.
Well, it's the best argument so far. But I still couldn't be another Jesse Childress.
Why, you!
I warned you, Narcissa. He's incorruptible.
You spoke to my men about pride. What's happened to yours?
Most of my pride was signed away at Appomattox. What I have left, I don't permit to stand between me and what I want.
You two make quite a team. Penny, Ante, Carlotta, and Maximilian.
Now let's use a direct approach. The mayor was right today. I have something planned. Something of immediate importance.
Go on.
I need men like your cowboys. All I can get. Mostly, I need you.
You can find your own way to Panama. You must have a map.
Money. That's what keeps men loyal.
Is it?
I'm down to nothing. But I know where there's gold for the taking. Fort Stark. The army paymaster arrived today. Money for the forts and the territory. The garrison's practically empty. The cavalry's out on the stake plains tracking down Santanta. A lightning raid will do it, no trouble at all.
Just like that.
If you lead them, Favor. This is the sort of thing you do best, I know. When it's done, we'll cross the Rio Grande, down the coast through Mexico. We won't even have to fight, we'll buy our way. You'll sit at my right hand, Favor, when we reach our goal.
You're out of your mind.
Enough of that.
This game you're playing in this dead house.
At my right hand, Favor.
Running up and down, booted and spurred, trading on poverty with wild promises. This isn't Virginia.
You clod, you fool. A man's only as good as his dream. I gave you your chance, but you are like the others. Just plant them in the mud. I don't need you. I'll get that money tomorrow myself, but you stay with your cows. You try to interfere with me and I'll kill you. Nobody turns his back on me. I'm Warren Millet, Emperor of Panama.
Yeah, what is it, Rowdy?
Well, what about,
What about what?
What about the colonel, Mr. Favor? And, she was a real beautiful woman.
The colonel plans to attack a United States fort tomorrow with our men. He's broke. He's got it all figured out. The cavalry will be out chasing Santanta. According to the colonel, all he'll have to do is rush the fort, and he's got enough money for everybody to live happily ever after.
He's got our men believing that?
You didn't see him drill. He talks to him, she just looks at him. He's got them believing that anything that happens to him is the best thing that ever happened to him.
They're our men, Mr. Favor. They're your drovers.
Yeah, I know that.
Come on, Fox.
Rowdy!
Yeah?
Come back here.
Yeah?
You have in mind.
You let me go in that house, Mr. Favor. He makes one move and you won't have any trouble anymore.
No, Rowdy. The answer's not in that house.
Are you through?
Did you hear how he talked to me? Me?
Stop.
Stop shouting! Why, Gil Favor's got more manhood in one little finger than your whole family line since John Smith and Pocahontas.
Stop it!
Just look at yourself, an overdressed windbag. Just look at this place.
Stop it, I say!
You're not telling me anything. You're not high-toned rich and almighty anymore. Well, I'm surprised Favor didn't laugh in your face.
You can say these things to me. I picked you up from nothing.
It was the most elegant saloon in New Orleans, and I could have married half a dozen men who could buy and sell you.
No more of this. I'm tired.
And I'm through. I'm leaving.
No! You can't.
You're letting something big slip right through your fingers, and all your words and shouting can't stop it.
Narcissa, don't leave me. Say you won't. Please.
Will you lead that raid on the fort tomorrow yourself?
Yes. A man's only as good as his dream. My own words, weren't they?
You can do it. Believe me, you can.
Of course I can. Huh. Why did I even bother with Favor?
We've no time to waste after what you told him. He's not going back and just tend his cows.
What?
Don't you see? He'll be going back to Nyosha. He's going to try to get those men away from you. You'll need them tomorrow.
You're right. You're always right, Narcissa.
I'll tell Zachariah to hitch up the buggy.
Jasper!
Colonel Millet says when we're gone, they don't raise cotton, just bananas. And they raise theirselves on trees. And then pretty little brown-skinned gals come along and shake them down. And all we gotta do is sell them for Yankee dollars.
Well, what's the matter with that, Brad?
I know cattle, I know buffaloes, and I know horses. I still don't know what's a banana.
Come on, Professor, strike up another tune. Here we go. Yeah!
That's my little baby buttermilk. Yeah. There, well, well. Yeah. Jesse, take good care of little buttermilk. Jesse always take good care of Miss Narcy, too. Uh-huh. Ah, yes, yes, I know. You go on back and have a good sleep. Huh? You have a good sleep.
Your words count, Warren. Don't tell them what has to be done. Don't even mention the fort. Let them find out about that when it's too late to turn back.
I know how to handle men, my dear.
Of course you do. That's what I mean. Make them swear by you so that nobody can turn them aside. You don't need anybody but yourself.
Nobody but you.
This is your moment. I'll wait for you upstairs.
Miss Narcy.
Why aren't you downstairs with the others?
I've been wanting to see you alone, but you wouldn't let me.
Jesse, this is no time to talk about us.
Oh, Miss Narcy, I've always been skittery around ladies, but with you it's different. Why, you didn't think I was a big clumsy ox, did you? Miss Narcy, when are we gonna get married? You as good as promised. You know, Miss Narcy, you're just everything there ain't no words for. I remember when I was a kid, standing out in front of that one-room lousy shack that I growed up in, looking out across Matagorda Bay, and the sky and the water was so clean. I was always looking for something that there just wasn't no words for. But when I first seen you, Miss Narcy, I knowed exactly what I was looking for.
Let go of me. I can't stand the sight of you.
Oh, don't say that.
You're worse than an animal.
Well, all them things you said to me, they didn't mean nothing. Why did you say them things?
Because Colonel Millet needed you to get the others.
Don't say no more! I'm all mixed up. I gotta scheme things out. I gotta understand. You shouldn't have done nothing like that, Miss Narcy. Nobody understands what goes on inside of me. Nobody cares. It ain't fair. It ain't fair.
Here's to the new Confederacy of Panama. The hour has struck at last.
Just what is going to happen tomorrow, Colonel? You never did tell us right up.
You'll get your orders from Captain Childress. Oh, yes. Somebody go and find him. Tell him to join me upstairs.
What's the matter, Mr. Favor? Can't you get your steers across the Devil River? What do you want?
I didn't come here to make a speech.
You ain't gonna get the chance.
But I thought you all ought to know what you've gotten yourselves into. You're going on a madman's picnic tomorrow. You don't...
He's dead. I killed him. Guess that means that you're gonna be taking orders from me from now on. Ain't that right, Miss Narcy? Go on, tell him I'm a better man than he ever was. He's just been giving you promises. I'll give you action. That's what you want, ain't it? No more marching, no more parading. You follow me and you... Well, what's the matter?
Ain't I a better man than he was? Why don't somebody say something?
There's nothing more to be said, Jesse.
You ain't gonna turn on me. I won't let you. Now get back, all of you. Get back there. You shoot at me, you'll kill her. Now get back. Don't you dare try to draw. Get out of here. Get down there.
Already. Don't make it worse. Jesse! You're making me come in after you, Jess.
Rowdy, keep everybody out here.
I never asked for none of this, Mr. Favor. Please don't blame me. Now who's gonna take care of little old Buttermilk?
Is the man taking names? Taking names. Death is the man.